Welcome to the Chidaiko tutorial for becoming human. I'm going to teach theme through air bocce. I want to use my hands because I think bocce and drums can sometimes be very distracting. You know, having to teach indoors during a pandemic, I think this is something that can be a benefit actually, that we can focus more on timing and rhythm and using our bodies. You actually learn how to form a better mental representation of space. And one that will hopefully translate well to your mental representation of the drum when you're actually in front of it. I want to really have a belief in my mind about where the center of the naname drum is, where the various points on the rim are that I'm going to want to hit. The more we can become specific about that, and even when we're hitting in space, have a particular point in space that we're stopping because we believe that the drum is there. If you do have a drum that you're practicing on, of course you can practice on that drum itself, but I would even recommend not actually hitting the drum and stopping just before you hit the drum or hit the rim. That trains you, again, to know where in space you are, as opposed to by ear saying, ah, I hit the drum somewhere on the drum. We're trying to train our position specificity. I'm actually going to think of the ends of my fingertips as being the ends of my bocce. When I do this, that means that I think the drum surface is right here. Not that I'm holding bocce and then the drum surface is a bocce length away from where I'm gripping. Whether you have bocce in your hands or nothing in your hands or something small like pens or chopsticks, please make sure to take really good care of your body. If something hurts, if something starts to tingle, please stop, please rest, please try it a different way. Let's not use the no pain, no gain mindset. I don't think it makes sense, especially in the middle of a pandemic. That's really not the time to, you know, need to go in for medical care. There's a short introduction to the piece, so let's start by learning that. Ichi, ni, so, re, donzu, konzu, donzu, kaka. You're gonna do that line three times. So it'll go so re, donzu, konzu, donzu, kaka, donzu, konzu, donzu, kaka. Third time, donzu, konzu, donzu, kaka. And then the last line that you'll tack on to the end goes like this. So re, donzu, konzu, kaka. So if I put those four lines together for the intro, it sounds like this. So re, donzu, konzu, donzu, kaka, donzu, konzu, donzu, kaka, donzu, konzu, donzu, kaka, donzu, konzu, kaka. I use this as a once upon a time to sort of set the stage. So we play it pretty loud. You could have multiple people playing Chudaiko in unison playing it, or you can have one play the first line, then the next person play the second line, and so on. Or you could have them layer in. You can also just have one sole player play through the whole thing by themselves. And you can think about how each of these different things would contribute to the story that you're trying to tell. One thing I'll let you know is that the next part in the song is the shime daiko players come in. Shimes tend to be a lot quieter than chudaiko, so don't totally overshadow the shime players. I want there to be a sense of fluidity going from the dons to the karas. Donzu, 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 splush, kara. Donzu, 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 splush, kara. Donzu, 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 kara. You see how it kind of splooshes up? And then the droplets fall back down onto the rim. That's what I'm picturing. I'm gonna do it without the splooshes and then with the splooshes.
Ichi, ni, so, re, donzu, konzu, donzu, kara, donzu, konzu, donzu, kara, donzu, konzu, donzu, kara, donzu, konzu, kara. Ichi, ni, so, re, donzu, konzu, donzu, kara, donzu, konzu, donzu, kara, donzu, konzu, donzu, kara, donzu, konzu,
I'm not hitting the katas directly at 12 o'clock on the top. I'm hitting them at more like 10 and 2 o'clock. I want to teach two different ways to do that ending line for the intro. You can choose which one you like better. So the rhythm is so re don su su kon su su kara su. After that first don, we've hit, right? Now from here, you can either keep this right hand, keep it at the drum, and then shift weight and stretch as much as you can. Bring that in, sploosh it up, right? Another option is to actually drop the right hand after it hits the don so that it's no longer kind of like stuck to the drum. So I can go don, bring it down while I pull this as far away as possible. Now the key here, when this left hand snaps back, I still want the sploosh effect. So that's gonna have to look like this. Sploosh, kara. So again, the two options are sore, don, kon, kara, or sore, don, kon, kara. Either way, we have this sploosh up effect. Keep it moving the whole time. I don't want to have like don, kon, don. Like, I don't want each hit completely separated. Go for more like don, kon, don. As I hit the first hand, that launches the next hand, and so on, right? So there's some kind of physical relationship between the hits. Your torso should be twisting to really get these big hits and rotate, rotate, rotate. For the last line, don, su, su, kon. You have so much time there to really twist pretty far away from the drum. Your weight will be shifted all the way out. That doesn't necessarily mean a horizontal translation. Your weight will just be shifted because you've rotated. That should be like really a moment of stretching. Play those katas really confidently too. It's always really disappointing when I hear don, se don, se don, ka ka. I want to hear don, se don, se don, ka ka. The next thing that happens is the Shimadaiko players play the alpha G. It's pretty long. It's twice as long as the entire intro that you just played. To daiko players, this is a choice point for your character. What are you doing during this time? You can do some acting or miming. You can dance in various ways. It's a question if you choose to just stand there frozen. Again, what does that mean for your story? Why are you frozen? I think if you know, you know, whether you're frozen or whether you're kind of bopping along or swaying or staring confused as to who those other Shima players are, whatever it is, if you know in your mind why you're doing it, it's going to make so much more sense on stage and you'll just be a lot more confident doing it. So please take this time to think about sort of creatively, what does this all mean and why are you doing what you're doing? Since the intro section was a once upon a time, I tend to think of these four bars of alpha G as really setting the stage, like starting to give the first details into the story. They're important. They're not just a moment where you don't have to play. All right, now it's time for theme. Theme is 8 lines long, but I find it more helpful to think about it as 4 double wide lines long. Sometimes I call theme theta because I like Greek letters. But the lines of theme are theta 1, theta 2, theta 3, theta 4. I'm going to sing theta 1 and then we'll break it down. Ichi, ni, sore, don, zu, kon, zu, don, kara, don, 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 kon, kara, sore. Don's, con's, don's, kara, don, don. So that's the first half of it, of theta 1. And that's going to go sore, right, left, right, right, left, right, left. Sore, don's, con's, don's, kara, don, don. The second half is the ending of intro. Sore, don's, con's, kara, su. So putting that together, we have sore, right, left, right, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left, theta 2. Let me sing through it and then we'll break it down. Sore, su, do, go, don, con, su, don, con, don, su, kara, su, kara, cha. So the first chunk of that is sore, su, do, go, don, con. So we have sore, su, right, left, right, left. Sore, su, right, left, right, left. The second chunk of that is su, don, su, con. Sore, su, right, su, left. Sore, su, don, su, con. Stitching together the first two chunks, we have sore, su, do, go, don, con, su, don, su, con. Sore, su, right, left, right, left, su, right, su, left. We'll do the last two chunks together. It goes sore, don, two, three, kara, su, kara, su, cha. Sore, right, two, three, right, left, su, right, left, su, both. Putting all of theta 2 together, we have sore, su, do, go, don, con, su, don, su, con, don, su, su, kara, su, kara, su, cha. Sore, su, right, left, right, left, su, right, su, left, right, su, su, right, left, both. So check out these details. We start with a crescendo from medium low to high. Sore, su, do, go, don, con, su, don, su, con, don. You can do a little bit of a crescendo with the karas in the second half of the line. Just make sure to keep them precise. So you could go, sore, don, two, three, karas, karas, cha. But whatever you do, make sure that that cha at the end has got just explosive amounts of energy. You can hit that cha pretty hard. You're gonna hit a don right after it, so you have to move pretty fast. But that just adds to the intensity of what you're gonna do. Let's stitch together lines 1 and 2 of theme. Sore, don, con, don, kara, don, 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 con, kara, do, go, don, con, don, con, don, kara, kara, cha. Intermission time. Let's learn how to count on our fingers. So most kids learn how to count 1, 2, 3, 4. But that's not how I learned how to count. I'm Indian, I'm Bengali, and this is what my family taught me. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. And then they do something with their thumb. I don't do the thumb thing because I don't understand how to count to 4 when I only have like 2 knuckles and a fingertip that looks like 3 to me. So I don't do that. This is my innovation. I just switch to my next hand. 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32. Now, this is, I think, actually helped me my whole life as a dancer, as a musician, and also as an electrical engineer. It's helpful because they all like binary numbers. In terms of music, in terms of taiko, I feel like I am always walking around with sheet music on my hands. I don't need pen and paper. I don't need a whiteboard. I don't need any of that. I don't need computer software. I just go 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 2, 3, 4, 3, 2, 3, 4, 4, 2, 3, 4. And if I need another 4 bars of music, hey, we got the other hand. You know, let's say I'm learning omiyage. You'll see me going, okay, sutonga doko doko, sutonga doko doko, sutonga doko doko, don, don, go doko. That's part of how I come to understand the rhythms that I'm being taught. Now, this is so flexible because I can analyze subdivisions a lot more easily. So if we have sutonga doko doko, and I'm like, huh, where does that don, where does it go? Because it sort of happened in midair somewhere and it's like hazy. Well, instead of making that line take up one finger, I can make it take up 2 fingers worth of time. So I can go sutonga doko doko. So now it takes up 2 fingers, right? And so I see su do. Okay, that's where it is. It falls on that knuckle. And I don't know, this is just a lot more precise to me than knowing, oh, it falls on the 2 or the one E of one E and a. I feel like this has been helpful for me to develop a visceral knowledge of exactly where hits should be.
Lines one and two together. Each, ni, sore, don't, can't, don't, kara, don't, can't, kara, doko, don't, kara, kara, cha.
Sometimes I was using a different quality of motion, and that builds tension. The point is that you start to set up an expectation with one kind of quality of motion, then whenever you break it, it's interesting. It'll draw people's eyes and they'll think, ah, something's going on, this is meaningful. So for me, the things that I'm setting up in contrast here in theme is this lilty, splooshy, I'm rocking in the waves kind of motion versus something sharp and intentional. And there's a lot of different kinds of tensions that you can set up, but part of what I like about thinking about movement this way is that even with fairly small or relatively simple motions, you can really do a lot. You can really elevate whatever movements you're doing by really focusing on how we do just simple left, right motions and adding this kind of intrigue to them. It means that when we do put in an arm circle or a spin or a bocce toss or something, those are even more exciting. So that's what I'm trying to give you the tools to do right now, to really milk all that you can out of every single hit. I tend to not just tell people exactly what to do or how to do a particular movement. I like to give people options, and it's because that allows you to tell the story. That allows you to use how you're feeling today to communicate different things to the audience or to communicate different things to the audience at different points in time, right? This theme, we're going to repeat this like 3 or 4 times during this piece. You can express different things through the same hits. And so this is what I'm hoping to give you the tools to do. All right, theta three. Let me sing the whole thing first. Sore, don't, can't, karas, don't, can't, don't, doko. Now, instead of breaking theta three down normally, I'm gonna let you in on a secret. If you look at theta one, the main hits have a structure kind of like this. At the first half, there's a don't, don't, don't. And then in the second half, we have something like a don't, don't. The way that I actually composed theta three is I was like, let's take the second half and put it at the beginning for theta three, and then the first half of theta one and put it at the end of theta three. Approximately. So that means that theta three has the structure of beginning with don't, con, something, something, and then the second half having the don't, con, don, something, something. So the first half of theta three we had sore, don't, con, kara, don. Ignore the last don for a minute. Sore, don't, con, kara. Now, back at the end of theta one, we had, and I'm gonna use my hands to show this, sore, don su su, con su su, kara su. So the kara was right there. This time at the beginning of theta three, we have sore, don su su, con su, kara su, don. So the kara is here. Theta one, it was up here. Theta three, it's now moved earlier, it's down here. See, I taught you this stuff for a reason. Okay, just to make sure everyone's got the sticking down for this first half of theta three, we have sore, right, su, su, left, su, right, left. What about the sit-don? Sasan, you didn't tell us which hands to play the sit-don with. Yeah, that's because different people play it differently, or people play it differently at different times, and really you can do whatever you want. I'll present a few different options. So let's talk about the second half of theta three. We have sore, donz, konz, donz, doko, doko, doko. So the donz, konz, don is all played pretty loud, and then you drop down and you do a little crescendo. Su, doko, doko, doko. Su, right, left, right, left, right, left. So now let's pick up the last don we had at the end of the first half of the line. One, two, three, don, donz, donz, donz. Doko, doko, doko. Now those four hits, the 1, 2, 3, don, 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 don. Let's talk about three different ways to play those. And this occurred because over the times that I've taught this piece, people have interpreted it different ways. And honestly, I thought they were pretty interesting. I think they mean different things because they force you to use your body differently. So first off, we're gonna play right, left, right, left. So we're gonna have 1, 2, 3, right, left, a right, a left. Doko, doko, doko. I think that one is very open and freeing. I think it's interesting because you start the sore, don, con, don, left, a right, a left, instead of starting with the right hand. But it still feels natural because you've just hit the pickup before it with your right hand. I think it's really freeing because you end with your left hand and then you have this moment where you can pause before going into that doko 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 crescendo. And I think that's really beautiful. The second option, we're gonna play left, right, left, right. So that'll go 1, 2, 3, left, right, a left, a right, doko doko doko. I think that one's really powerful. It preserves the motif of don, to con, to don, being a right, a left, a right thing that you do with your body. Now the third way is my favorite way. We're gonna go right, right, left, right. So we have 1, 2, 3, right, right, a left, a right. What I like about that is that it's very insistent. In order to get those two right hits in a row, you really use your torso and it just comes off really persistent and punchy. So especially when we're going really fast, like playing this at the end of the song, I really love packing those don, don, con, don, doko, doko, doko. I really love doing that. To be perfectly honest, I don't think very hard about which one I play. I just let the moment guide me. I've practiced all of them, so I know whatever comes out will be good. Let's stitch theta 2 and theta 3 together. So we have so, re, si, doko, don, con, don, con, don. Karats, karats, cha, don't, can't, karats, don't, can't, don't, doko, doko, doko. So that transition from 2 to 3 was pretty fast. I really love just slamming that cha and pulling back as fast as I can to get a huge hit for that first don at the beginning of theta 3. And that'll be especially important when you're playing this at double time. Don't just go cha don like something small. Really, the fact that you don't have a lot of time between the cha and the don, see it as an opportunity and really go all out. It's the kind of thing that just adds so much energy to the piece. Lines 1, 2, and 3, here we go. Ich, ni, so, re, don, con, don, kara, don, 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 con, kara, doko, don, con, don. Con dons, carats, carats, cha dons, cons, carats, don dons, cons, dons, doko, doko, doko. Let's say I want to play that theta 3 a little bit differently. Ich, ni, so, re, dons, cons, dons, kara, don, don, dons, cons, kara, si, doko, don, dons. Dons, con dons, carats, carats, cha dons, cons, cara, con dons, dons, don, doko, doko, doko. Finally, theta 4. Now, theta 4 is going to have different ending tags in the second half of it, but I'm just going to teach you the plain version, which just ends in a don. Okay, so it goes like so, re, don, do, con, go, don. Doko don 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 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So that's the plain version. Let's break down the first half. So re don do con ku don. That's so re right right left left right. So it sounds like loud soft loud soft loud. So re right right left left right. The second half of that line we just had so re. Don, do, con, go, don, su, do, go, don, con, don. So we have so, re, su, right, left, right, left is the rest of the first half of that line. The second line of theta 4 is Don, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now, all of that is gonna change for the different ending tags, but let's glue together this kind of blank theta 4 ending. Sore, don, do, con, go, don, su, do, go, don, 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 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Again, sore, right, right, left, right, sit, right, left, right, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I want to go back to the crescendo that we had at the end of theta 3. So we have sore, su, do, go, do, go, do, go, don, do, con, go, don, do, go, don, don, don. The reason I wanted to bring that up is because I think of the beginning of theta 4 is actually the end of the crescendo, the top. So we have su, do, go, do, go, do, go, don, do, con, go, don. So that don, con, don. So that allows line 3 to really flow directly into line 4 naturally. All of line 3 and 4 together. So re, don, cont, kara, con, don't, cont, don't. Doko, 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 don, do, con, go, don't. Doko, don, don, don. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now, what flows into line 3? We have cha, don, con, right? Line 2 starts with the su. All right, so putting 2, 3, and 4 together, we have so, re, su. Doko don kont, don't, kon don't, karat, karat, cha, don't, kont, karat, don't, kont, don't, doko, 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 don't, kon, go, don't, doko, don't, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Let's do the whole theme. Ich, ni, so, re, don't, kont, don't, kara, don't. Cons, caras, doko don, cons, don, con don't, caras, caras, cha don't, cons, cara, don, cons, don't, cons, doko, 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 don, do, con, go, don, doko, don, don't, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now, we just played that against the metronome. But actually, there's going to be a few different backbeats that you play theme over. The first time, you'll play it over the simplified alpha G, which is just alpha 0 over and over again. So that sounds like so re, tere, teka, tere, tereka, and that'll just be looping. The second time you play it through, you're going to have the full alpha, so it's going to have all the fun little endings. You can check out the video on that. That's going to sound more like so re, tere, teka, tere, tereka, tere, teka, tere, teka, 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 tere, teka, tere, tereka, tere, teka, tere, tereka, tere, tereka. The third time, you will have a totally different G under it, and that G is called beta instead of alpha. Get it? Okay. So beta sounds like so re, tere, tere. The last time you play a theme through, you'll be playing it twice as fast, double time, and there'll be a totally different G under it, totally different feel. That one sounds like so re, tere tuku dance, tuku dance, dance, then, tuku teke tuku dance, then, get teke tere tuku dance, tuku dance, dance, then, tuku teke tuku dance, then, get teke, and you're going dance, 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 kara don, don, dance, count, kara. So you're going to want to really practice theme so that you can deal with all these variations of what it's going to sound like. And also, the more you practice it, the more you're going to be able to express different aspects of a story that you're trying to tell, different emotions, different events that are going on. So yeah, keep practicing it. Now, as a way of previewing the rest of the piece, I'm going to teach you what all the different theta endings are. Each of them contains a little bit of a hint of what's coming up in the next verse. And the way that I originally designed these theta endings is that they're meant to help keep the group together to understand what verse is coming up next, since we have this chorus, verse, chorus, verse, chorus structure. I had a different Naname player serve as the verse captain for that verse. And so whoever was the verse captain would be the person who played the theta tag. So everybody else would just play the end of theta 4 the way that we just played it, ending with so re, don do con go dons, do go don, don don. And then it would be the verse captain who actually plays this theta tag. And that helps everyone know exactly which verse is coming up next. The first verse is called Abacus for reasons which no longer make any sense. Sorry, but the name stuck. So Abacus is based on Alpha 3. So if you remember the Alpha 3 ending, it goes like so re do do don ka ka don. And the rhythmic motif that we have in Abacus is don zu ka ka don. So re don zu ka ka don zu ka ka don. We'll go over that more later. You see how so re do do don zu ka ka don versus don zu ka ka is related, right? The theta ending tag that goes into this, theta ab, sounds like so re su ka ka don. So that whole last line ends up being so re don 2 3 4 su ka ka don. So let's do theta 4 plus theta abacus. So that's going to start with the don do con go don. Ich ni so re don do con go don su doko don 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 2 3 4 su ka ka don. The second verse is called Layer Cake. So that one has rhythmic motifs that go like so re don su kara ka ka don su kara ka ka don su do don. The theta ending tag that goes into Layer Cake called theta LC goes so re don kara ka ka don. So counting that out a little bit better, we have don 2 3 4 kara ka ka don. Hop. Breaking down that karakaka motif, that's gonna go so re right left right left karakaka so re right left right left karakaka so re right left right left. So adding the don to that, we have so re karakaka don so re right left right left right. Stitching that together for theta layer cake, we have so re don 2 3 4 kara ka ka don. Ich ni so re right 2 3 4 right left right left right. Let's do theta 4 plus theta layer cake. Ich ni so re don do con go don su do go don 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 2 3 4 kara ka ka don. The third verse is called Beta Drive, and it goes with the Beta Giuchi. The Theta BD tag that leads into Beta Drive is a little bit more complicated than the other ones. With the other ones, you got to go don, two, three, and you had some time, but here it leads directly into it. Beta Drive has a rhythmic motif like so re, do kont kara, do kont kara, do kont hup, do kont kara, do kont kara, do kont. And so the beta drive tag is that line. So re, right, left, su, right, left, su, right, left, su, right, left, su, right, left. So re, do, kont, karat, do, kont, karat, do, kont. Now, how does this attach onto theta 4? So we have so re, don, do, kon, go, don, su, do, go, don, don. Dokot karat, dokot karat, doko hup. Let's do that again. So re, don do kon go don su, doko don don, dokot karat, dokot karat, doko. So part of what's complicated here is that before you were able to prepare so re su, doko don don don, and you could keep this left hand down. But for theta BD, you have to actually prepare both hands because you're about to hit a dokon instead of a don. So watch me. So re don do kon go don su doko don don doko kara doko. Kara doko. And you saw I went doko, don, don, and brought both of my hands up. The last theta tag you have to learn is for the ending of the piece. You'll be playing theme in double time, but I'm going to teach it to you in just normal time. It's inspired by Alpha 4, which is a motif that comes up at the ends of verses several times. So it comes up at the end of Full Alpha, it comes up at the end of Abacus, it comes up at the end of another verse called QRSTs that'll be in the latter half of the piece. So it's a pretty common motif. And it sounds like so re don con don con. So if I tack that on to the don at the beginning of this tag, we have so re don, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 don con don con. So my sticking for that is so re right, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 right left, right a left. So let's put theta 4 and theta end together. So re don do con co don su do co don don don. And 2 and 3 and don cons don con. Let's do theme with theta abacus ending. Ich ni so re dons cons dons kara don don dons cons kara su doko don cons dons con dons karats karats cha dons su cons kara. Don't, can't, don't, can't. Doko, 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 don, do, con, go, don't. Doko, don, don, don't. Ka, ka, don. Okay, that's it. Theme really makes me feel like a rock star, and I hope that y'all practice it and can really make it sparkle.